Stay fresh music.
Yo, so how's it going, guys? Welcome back to another GTA 5 video. So as you guys are probably aware, this week Rockstar Games are rolling out some of the best money in RP promotions that you guys have definitely got to make the most of. So last night I did upload a video showing you guys what is potentially the best method out of all of them is how to make the most money from grinding double money and double RP on the VIP work and challenges. So I will leave a link to that video down below in case you guys haven't seen it. However, not only are Rockstar Games offering double money and double RP on all of the VIP work and challenges, they're also offering double money and double RP on every single stunt race in the game, which if played in the right way can earn you guys tons of money very easily. For practically just playing races, you guys could be earning tons of money. However, I am aware that a lot of you guys may not know what is the best way to grind these stunt races out so you guys can earn the most amount of money in the shortest period of time. But not only that, in this video I'm going to break down all of the different payouts you can earn, but I'm also going to break down if you guys prefer to play these races solo or with a friend, so you guys can work out is it worth just grinding this method out solo, or how much you guys can earn for each friend that you get into your races, which can end up making a massive difference to your final payout. So as always, if you guys do enjoy this video and you would like to see me cover more epic money and RP guides in the future, all I ask is you do drop a like down below, and also feel free to subscribe as I do post daily GTA 5 videos. Without further ado, let's get into the video. Okay, so as I did mention, firstly I'm going to cover how you guys can grind this method if you guys do want to play solo, and like I did mention later in the video, I will compare it if you guys have got some friends with you, showing the difference in payout that you guys will actually make. Like I said, there can be a lot of benefits to doing this solo because you're always going to be getting the same consistent payout. It's not going to drop and there's no risks of you like finishing third, fourth or last. Plus you could consider it as an AFK method, so it's like stress-free, very easy. Now if you guys are going to do this solo route to grind this method, what you actually want to do is be in a free roam session, you want to press start, go down to playlists, and you want to add as many of these races that you want to do when you're grinding this method out. So this is completely up to you, depending on how long you guys are actually going to spend on the game. Me, I was doing it for roughly just under an hour, so what I've done is I added 6 races, as they're pretty fun races to do. I'm not gonna lie, it's not gonna feel like you guys are grinding this for money, because time really does fly by when you're doing these races. So like I said, just add as many of these races as you want. I would say do a minimum of 3 just so you guys can get that playlist bonus right at the end when you finish the playlist. But other than that, like I said, you can do 10 in this playlist, you can do 6, just depending on how much money you guys want to make, as the payout is not going to drop whatsoever, so it is unlimited. Now once you guys have chosen the races you like the look of, go ahead and save this playlist. Now another tip I'm going to give you guys is maybe choose a bunch of the new races that haven't got a tick next to them, because if they've got a tick next to them, that means you guys have played the races before. So by playing a race that you haven't played before, you'll be able to learn the circuit in case you guys come across it again when you're racing your friends, giving you guys a little bit of advantage. Nonetheless, once you guys start the playlist up, the first and most important part you guys want to remember is to never finish these races under 4 minutes. That is the most important benchmark to do with these races and how the payouts work. So as you guys can see on screen, I managed to finish this Rocket Voltic race in just under 4 minutes, and I only received a measly 5k, which is not good at all. However, if you guys pay attention to the clock in the bottom right, by me literally just sitting in this mission for an extra 18 seconds, so it passes the 4 minute mark, my money will literally double, taking it well over 10k for only 4 minutes work, which is extremely good. Now an important point to remember is each lap on these new stunt races is literally around 3.5 minutes, so a lot of the times you guys will finish these races just under the 4 minute mark, so you actually want to pay attention to the clock in the bottom right. As I think we can all agree, being able to double your money by only spending an extra 10-15 seconds in a mission is insane, and you guys will be able to increase that more by spending a further 2 minutes in a race. So by finishing the race in just over 6 minutes, your payout will increase by 10k to just under 14k, so about 13.5k and a very nice 3600 RP. However, to earn the max payout from doing this solo method, you guys will have to spend a further 1.5 minutes in the race, so it passes the 8 minute mark, and that will increase yet again to just under $17,000. However, the RP will remain the same, around 3600, and that is 100% 100% the new cap on all of these races. I know a lot of people have been putting out false information saying spend up to 16 minutes in races to earn the max payout. That is no longer the case. These people do not spend their time testing out these methods for you guys like I do. So as you guys can see on screen, 16 minutes passes in the race and I still receive the same $16,000. The only other way to increase this is with players in your mission. 8 minutes is the time cap to earn the max payout for all of these races. That is another important thing. All of these races work the same. I've also seen people putting out information saying always do this race because it pays more than the Rocket Vaultic. All of that is also bullshit. The only determining factors are the players and the time spent in the mission. So now you guys know that 8 minutes is the time cap. You guys saw that you earned about $17,000 for spending 8 minutes in the mission. However, if you guys can remember, by spending only 4 minutes in the race, we managed to get a very nice $10,000. So if I was to do this race 5 times in 4 minutes, I would get $50,000, which would only take me about 20 minutes because I'm only spending 4 minutes on each lap. Whereas if I was to wait the full 8 minutes every time, I'd be earning around 41K, so I'm making $10,000 less every couple races if I was to do the more longer method. So you guys, like I said, can work out what suits you guys best, whether you just want to keep on repeating every 4 minutes to earn the higher payouts, or like I said, sit AFK. Maybe if you guys just want to watch some of my YouTube videos or go for your dinner, you'll be able to play this game based around you. Now, as I did mention, there is another multiplier or another factor that Rockstar do take into account when calculating your payout, and that is basically the amount of players that are in your race at any given time. Now, I am aware that we all play GTA 5 different. We all have different amount of friends we can get online, and we all even have a different skill ability when it comes to racing. Some of you guys might be 10 out of 10 beast, but you don't have that many friends. Some of you guys might play with a shit ton of players, but you're not that good at racing. But I do know one thing is that we all have at least one other friend, cousin, or brother that we can all play GTA 5 with. I guarantee all of you guys at least know one other person that you've played computer with over the years that is usually your go-to person when it comes to either grinding money or just having a bit of jokes online. So taking that into account, as I mentioned earlier, you guys will be earning 10k by doing this solo for just 4 minutes, but by getting one other person in your race, you guys will be earning an extra $4,000 every single time for literally just doing nothing, exactly just over 4 minutes. But by having one other person in your race, you're able to earn an extra 4k every single race. And your friend, you might be thinking, oh well, he's only going to get 2k, there's no point of him doing it. No, he will still be earning a very nice $9,800, so practically the same as if you was doing it solo, just slightly less because you guys earned 10k, he's going to be earning 9.5. But for only 4 minutes of racing, I think we can all agree that is extremely high. So I can see why a lot of people might want to do you win one race and then you let your friend win one race and then you win one race, because by doing it that way, you'll actually be earning, like I said, more than by doing it by yourself solo, because you're also going to be getting that player bonus. And because the loser still gets 9k, which is only a couple $100 less for coming first solo, you guys really have nothing to lose out by getting an extra friend in here. And the time bonus will also include if you guys are doing it with a friend, so you will be able to earn up to $18,000 for going just over 6 minutes, and your friend will also earn a very nice 12.5. And of course, if you guys go to the max cap time of 8 minutes spent in the race, one of you guys will be earning a very nice 22.5k, while the other one is still going to be getting a very nice $15,500. So let's say you won one and your friend won one, we're talking a guaranteed just under 30k for completing just 2 races, which in all honesty, if you guys have played these stunt races, like I said, will not even feel like half the time because they're so goddamn fun and unique. I've got to say, me personally, as you guys probably know, I'm not the biggest racing fan in GTA 5 online, but I can still appreciate this goddamn DLC for the pure fun and unique factor to it. So now you guys are fully clued up on how to maximize the payouts depending on the time spent in the game or the number of players. It is worth mentioning, of course, you guys can take another route and chance your luck by going into a bigger lobby with much more players. Of course, naturally, it's not really a method by doing it this way, hence the reason why I broke the method down earlier. But this way, obviously, is going to offer you guys bigger rewards with bigger risks. So now you guys understand how to maximize the payout. These payouts should make much more sense to you guys. So as you guys can see here, with just 6 players, the winner was able to earn a very nice $28,000 for spending just over 6 minutes in the game. game. Here you can see 6 players for going under 4 minutes was only $10,000. However, with 16 players, so a full lobby, you guys will only be earning up to $26,000 if the race finishes under 4 minutes. And like I did say, every single player will count towards that winner's final pay. So as you guys can see here, 16 players. If one player was to back out during the loader menu or before it starts, the winner's bonus is going to decrease yet again down to $24,000. So as you guys can see here, 15 players under 4 minutes is the usual lap time you guys will see when doing these races. The winner only got $24,000. So when you guys see these payouts, take into mind what I showed you guys earlier. I'm pretty sure you guys will be able to use your brain to stack some serious money best suited to how you guys play the game. Hopefully you guys do appreciate me covering this method in full detail so all of you guys will be able to grind it, whether you're rank 1 or 100. And if you guys are going to do it with friends or more players and not the solo method, do be sure to leave a comment down below if your gamer tag or your PSN. Put together a nice little group of you guys to grind this method out. Or you guys can come and join one of my GTA 5 crews. I will leave a link to all of my crews down low in the description. I will say the crews do fill up very quickly, so I will kick in active players in my next paint job video over the weekend. Stay tuned for that video. Nonetheless, that is going to do it for me guys. An awesome money making method that all of you guys should definitely be grinding out as of right now. If you guys do enjoy these money guides and want to see more in the future, all I ask is you drop a like down below. Feel free to subscribe if you guys are new, as I do post daily GTA 5 videos. Thanks a lot for watching guys, and I'll see you in my next video.